Hey guys, my 12-week-old boxer seems to show territorial behavior with my other dog. Bites at her when we give her attention and always has to be the closest to us. What should we do about this?
Teach your dog, who's that?
Justin.
Justin, go to on my YouTube channel, I've got a couple of videos titled Out. One of them means out, meaning literally get the fuck out of here. Okay? What you're doing is, and this is literally how you set it up. Like, I don't know if it shows this in the video. It might show it in the video, but you can actually call your other dog up to you and you say to your other, the dog that's actually has to be first, you say out, that dog will end up actually walking, if not running away. That's the end result, and it doesn't take long. The video shows you how to do it. It's a free video. Lots of free content up there on social, on my YouTube channel. But use my YouTube channel, guys. Please use it. Next. Hey, we're live. How's everybody going? How's everybody doing?
Stopping by to give thanks. Continuing education for dog owners and trainers is mandatory. Grateful.
Awesome. Dogs just stop doing bad shit. It's incredible. And then you get to start training your dog. Yeah! Hey. Hello. Hey, everybody. Hey, all you cool cats and kittens. God. Hey, everybody. How are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Sally Canine Training. And this is the What Would Jeff Do show. It is Monday. It's Monday. It's Monday over here at the training center. And how's everyone doing? Pretty soon we'll be able to say day 186 of quarantine.
We're probably on that already.
No. What it feels like, and then the truth.
I know. What is it, like day 21 now?
Day 3. 186. No. I know. Hi, everybody. How are you doing?
I'm not even on the show. I'm just sitting here listening to you.
Log on to the show.
This is great.
Log on to the show. It's step two, actually. Step one is me starting it. This is a Q&A show. What you'll do is you'll ask your questions. I'll give the answer. You'll ask your questions. Joelle will read them. I'll give you the answer. Joelle does answer some of the questions because she can answer them definitely more complete and things like that. And that's the What Would Jeff Do show. I talk about, you can hear me use the word punishment a lot. You can call it a punisher, call it a correction, call it an aversion, call it an intolerable consequence, call it anything you want. But in order to stop an unwanted behavior, which is why most people tune into this show, you have to give your dog a correction. Meanwhile, on the flip side, we're on the training center here, and we do tons of reward-based training. We clicker train, marker train every single dog that comes in here, so that's how they learn their commands. So that's how dogs learn their commands. But to stop stuff, you got to learn the art of correction. One of the things to always remember is you're not upset. You're not mad. So there's no yelling. There's no screaming. You're not angry. You're not upset at the dog. It's just a matter of fact. Mm-hmm. You can't do that. And then we've got something called Jeff Gellman Seminars, which obviously we're not touring anywhere right now. But we had 28 planned for 2020. We don't know how many we're going to be doing in 2020. We're playing it by ear.
Here. The tissue box works just fine.
Okay. I'll put this here just in case. We're playing it by ear. We're seeing, we're going to take it, month to month. Right now, the next 2 months of April and May, we're not doing any. But we're looking for a kick-ass second 6 months of this year and moving forward. We still have dogs that come in here every day. Mm-hmm. We still have the dogs here for board and train. We're an essential business. People need their dogs taken care of. People need their dogs rehabbed. And things are good. Things are really, really looking good. Tomorrow on our Patreon channel, if you go to patreon.com/solidcaninetraining, I'm doing a Zoom, which will enable me to do more interactive. Like, remember on some of my, if you're a regular fan of this show here, how many times have I said, I need more information? I'm not going to give you advice like with just written information without me asking you all these questions. Now I'll be able to ask you questions like I do in my Skypes. So that's something that's for my Patreon followers are going to be able to benefit from. And I'll probably do them, especially during this whole crisis, I'll probably do them more than once a week. I'll probably just, who knows what I'll do? Who knows what this will turn into? I really, really enjoy my Skypes a lot. I love my Q&As like this, and I think I'm going to love those as well. So that's really, really exciting. There's something called Top Chat here, and that's a dollar sign at the bottom of your screen. And when you click on that, what happens is, number one, you throw us a little bit of cash, but your question goes to the top of the queue. and we answer that. Now, you do not have to pay to play. We do an hour show now. So right, just to let everybody know, we've made two small changes to the show. It goes from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. It's a one-hour show. And then also, we're not doing it on Saturday nights anymore. We're doing it on Friday nights. So we're doing a Monday, Wednesday, Friday night show. And we did that because a lot of the times when we're on the road, Saturday nights just didn't work. It was too much pressure.
Yeah.
There's a lot of pressure.
Seminar, tired, traveling.
Time zone. Dinner out with a host maybe.
Yep.
Or just getting back to that. And we're always hunting for Wi-Fi too. So and usually on a Friday night, wherever we're staying at the Airbnb, like we got enough Wi-Fi historically. So let's just jump right in.
All right. Melissa said good evening, Jeff and Joelle and everyone in the chat.
Hey, Melissa. Love you.
Michelle Anderson.
Happy 1 month old birthday to your baby.
Yeah. Michelle Anderson said good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, what's up? What's going on in Calgary there?
Barista boy. Thank goodness for the prong punisher. No more of me worrying about having enough hot dog to finish the daily walks. Hallelujah.
Yeah. Thank God for that.
Yeah. Cheryl, hi Jeff and Joelle. Hope you're doing well, along with everyone at your center and everyone in the chat.
Thank you. We are all doing well. We got up early this morning, had my coffee, walked over to our gym right here. We're just talking about how nice the gym is here, right here at the training center. We built a gym, talked about, we did that, had a nice workout. Then we ran the dogs. And then we just had a great day.
Got shit done.
We got shit done today.
Filmed a new separation anxiety
Separation video. Anxiety video is filmed. That's going to be going up sometime this week. It's only Monday. That'll go up this week. I'm excited about that. A couple of new ideas brewing around. A lot of good stuff happening. I hope everything's going well with all of you. Just remember, guys, that you can turn this into something great. And I'm not ignorant to the facts. I'm not ignorant to what's going on in the world. I'm not ignorant to the people that are dying. I'm not ignorant to that at all. What I'm saying is, now is a really good time to get your shit together, to self-evaluate, and to make yourself great. No fucking excuse now. Don't got the time. Really? All you got is
time. We got nothing but time.
No, well, I mean, but there are people that are working from home still full time.
True.
So, next.
Oh my gosh, I lost the comments. Hold on.
What?
This is so weird. Where did the comments go?
Scroll all the way up.
What? I am all the way up.
You're not on my show. Okay.
Da-da-da. What the heck? Oh, live chat. All right, I'm
okay,
back.
Okay, got it?
Cool. Yep, CT Vader. Hey guys, just wanted to say hi and hope you all are safe, well, and sane. Can't stay too long, but wanted to pop in to say thanks for everything.
Yes to all three. You too as well.
Belinda adopted an Indian paria from India who's basically a rescued street dog. He's 10 months old. He loves to chase squirrels in our yard.
Yep.
Should I work on stopping this behavior or let him chase?
Okay. Number one, it doesn't make a difference what the breed of dog is. Okay? Because all dogs, not all dogs, but most dogs chase squirrels. Should you let the dog continue to do it? Do you want to own a squirrel chasing dog? That's the question. If you do, then don't stop it. If you don't, then stop it. Next.
Melissa posted the link to Skype with you.
Oh, awesome. Thank you.
Dog tough, dog training. Hi, I love your work. I have binged almost all of your videos. Absolutely changed my dog for the better. I have a question. My dog sometimes doesn't perform commands, punish or practice.
Okay. How many repetitions have you done? When it comes to obedience, have you done 300 to 500? Does your dog have a full understanding of the command? And usually a good way to do that is, if you're not using food anymore, whip out the food. Your dog does the commands spot on. Your dog knows the command. So then you would correct for non-compliance of a known command. When it comes to obedience, we only correct for non-compliance of a known command if the dog actually knows the command. You know, but jumping up on the counter, oh, you learn in the moment. Getting in the trash, you learn in the moment. Barking out the front window, you learn at the moment. But down, sit, place, heel, recall, we take lots of time, lots of reps. Next.
Tracy, hope you two are well. I have a question. How do you handle excessive whining in the kennel? The dog is an 8-year-old Jack Russell Terrier. After a 3-hour hike, he whined immediately.
Right. So you tiring your dog, we're huge advocates of exercise, huge advocates of proper nutrition. In fact, we feed raw. We've got a great raw book right on our website. You can go check that out. What I'm saying is, yes, exercise is good, but tiring your dog out doesn't stop whining. A correction, a punisher will stop whining. So what do you do? In fact, we talked about that in our separation anxiety video. You can apply a punisher, everything from a squirt bottle to a bonker to hitting the side of the crate, hitting the top of the crate, to throwing a bonker at the crate, to pulling the dog out and bonking the dog, to telling your dog to shut the fuck up. But that should be followed up with, you know, a consequence. So that's how you stop whining. Next.
Kathy, hey, be happy for me. The foster dog that I've worked with for almost 2 months has been adopted. He should go to his new home in the next few days. Bittersweet, but I like the adopter. We'll do well with him.
Awesome. Awesome. Congratulations.
E, would I need to submit video footage of my dog's problem to do a Skype?
No, you don't have to, but you can. But you do it after you've booked and paid for the Skype. Don't do it. And what you'll do is, Maddie, who will book the Skype, you'll send it to her. She'll get it to me. But you don't need to. I know what your dog is doing. I've seen it enough times. But you can also show it to me while we're Skyping. And show it to me while we're Skyping. So I'm not going to be surprised by anything your dog is doing. I've worked with too many dogs over my career, and you will not surprise me. Next.
Hannah, hi guys. Is there a way to record your live chats to watch later?
We've already done that for you. Go to YouTube, and they're on YouTube. Next.
Melissa said, oh, thanks, Jeff and Joelle. I appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Dog tough dog training. Once again, thank you. Such a big inspiration. You've helped me train my service dog, and it's made my life so much better.
Awesome. Proud of you. Next.
Gunslinger, I have a 7-month-old puppy who constantly wants to bite my hands. She thinks she is playing, but I'm not.
Right.
And she won't stop biting, nipping my hands.
Correct.
What should I do to get her to stop?
You correct that. So, 7-month-old, we can call it a puppy. I'm going to call it a fucking dog, though. Yeah, I swear a lot. If this is the first time on this show, by the way. And it seems like I might be swearing a lot tonight. I don't know why. The fuck word just keeps coming out, you know?
You haven't had one of these shows in a long time.
Where I've been saying fuck
swear
a lot?
Swear word.
Yeah.
Swear show.
So, hide your kids. Hide your wives.
Kids, hide your wives. Jeff's swearing at everybody.
That's right. It's like, I like your show, but I want my kids to watch and you swear too much. Well, freaking tell your kids to watch something else, you know? So this is the thing. You correct the dog. You apply a punisher to the dog. You put your mouth on me, it's going to suck. So that's what you got to do. Of course the dog thinks it's playing. Why? Because you've never told it it's not playing in a way the dog understands. So what do? Remote collar on the dog, say no, correct. Bonker. If you know what a bonker is, just Google my name, okay? You'll know what a bonker is, all right? Because 10 million people around the world should know what a bonker is by now. Bonk. The bottom line is this, make biting your hands suck. Oh, the dog will become afraid of you. No, it won't. Dog will know not to bite your hands. None of my dogs bite my hands. Your dogs don't bite your hands. Your dogs aren't afraid of you.
Nope.
My dogs aren't afraid of me. Next.
Sophia, hey guys, when I put the e-collar on Brew, we're in the beginning stages of e-collar. It seems like he becomes unmotivated, mopey, and he acts like he's distrustful of me. Is that normal-ish in your experience?
I don't want to say normal-ish. Yes, we've seen it. Yes, it happens. It also could be your perception of it. Also, your dog might go into a different state of mind. But also, let's make sure we're treating our training equipment maybe as a lifestyle, not just something we do when we're going to, you know, it's like, so wake up in the morning, put the training equipment on, rotate it every 3 or 4 hours. The end of the night, take the training equipment off. We do tons of food. All our remote collar training is layered over our existing training, which we're doing, which is food-based training. Next.
Cheryl, Jeff, you are so right about using this difficult time to make plans and do whatever you need to do. I've used Skype before, but now I'm learning to use Zoom for sessions and did my first Zoom.
Good. Yeah, I'm learning too. I've been Skyping for a very long time. I've never had a need for Zoom, but, you know, I've always done remote teaching. So, but now I want to start doing it in groups. So it's going to be a lot of fun. Next.
Kinsella, brand new watcher. I followed Julie's canine training and she recommended you.
Oh, that's nice. We recommend a lot of folks to her.
Love, yeah. Julie. What's your approach with deaf dogs for the e-collar? Struggling with an insecure dog that shuts down with any correction.
Okay, number one, you don't need to use it for correction. So this is what I want you to do. Keep a leash on the dog. We train deaf dogs almost the same as we train hearing dogs. We actually give them the verbal too, but we also just give them hand signals. You know, this is our good, this is our cut it out, and then we give them hand signals on the command. So we use a lot more leash guidance. We start with the basics, but there's no reason you can't train your deaf dog to be on par with a hearing dog. Next.
Holding on, dog training. Okay, Lightning Bolt head dog came in as a crate breaker. Now only wants to go back to the crate. Temper tantrum. Acts like I'm killing him when I ask for simple obedience. Only likes place. Correcting equals worse.
Well, when correcting in the crate? Who's that, Ashley?
Yeah.
Ashley, correcting in the crate? When are you correcting the dog? So equals worse? You could be underwhelming your dog. Or it's a battle of wills. We have dogs that go, oh, really? And they go into defense. So you might have one of those dogs. So that's where we take those dogs out, bonk them, put them back in the crate, do crate drills. What I want you to do is do crate drills. Leash on the dog, out of the crate, in the crate, out of the crate, in the crate. But watch my crate video on how to have a dog, they pause, tell them to kennel up, open up the crate door. If they try to rush out, you close the door, open up the crate door, you get that pause, they understand what the break is, break, they come out, crate drills, 20 times, 30 times, 40 times. And then teach them how to down in the crate. But you absolutely have to correct for nonsense.
No, it sounds like he only wants to go back in the crate now. Like he doesn't want to work.
Oh,
he just wants to run into
the crate. Oh. So leave the crate door closed and have him work. He's just being a dick, most likely. And a lot of people will be, oh, he's probably tired. Tired my ass. Take the leash off him. He'll probably run around your freaking 20 acres. Next.
Tracy, what is the difference between the micro educator and the mini?
It's about a 25% difference in size. So it's a little bit thinner. Price-wise, I believe it's the same. Range-wise, I believe it's the same. Just go on their website. Go to ecower.com. You'll get all the specifics on that. Next.
Hoku, if my dog pulls because it's scared to walk by a certain area, what should I do? She has a prong and e-collar on.
So number one, don't let the dog pull. Don't let the dog pull. A lot of people let the dog pull. What we do is we're like, oh, you have a hard time with manhole covers or storm grates. Interesting. Or A-frames outside stores. Like dogs have fears of these. So what do? Circle back around. All right. Most people, what they're doing with the dog, just because you have, guys, the prong collar is a tool. The remote collar is a tool. You still need to know the training. You still got to do the training. So what you're doing is you're letting the dog control the walk. Take the walk back. No, you're going to walk. We're going to walk really slow past this distraction. And if you need to use a little bit of space, use a little space. But we're going to walk slow. We're going to walk slow past this distraction. Next.
E, any advice for dealing with people who feel they can have their dogs off leash walking or at the park? Doesn't mix well with a dog who lunges and growls and doesn't want dogs coming up to him.
Okay, so two separate things. If their dog is off leash minding its own business, I actually don't have a problem with that at all. But if a dog is either on leash or off leash and runs up to your dog, I tell the people to get their dog away from me. Now, if your dog is lunging at dogs that are just walking by, minding their business, whether they're on leash or off leash, that's on you to fix. So, you know, but I'm not a big fan of off leash dogs running up to any dog in an on leash area. That's a very, very dangerous precedent. And I don't care if it's friendly or not. Next.
Barista boy said, can I leave a prong on all day?
All depends on your dog. Some dogs get irritated. But theoretically, only when you're training. That's one of those tools that you have on. You know, if there's no leash attached to it, you're not training. You're not training. So it has no use. But you could. I mean, I've got German Shepherds I could leave, or if I had a husky, I could leave the prong on all day. But we've got some pitties here that if we leave the prong on too long, they'll probably end up getting irritation. Next.
Kathy, been getting out more with the dogs, doing a lot more off-leash. There aren't so many people out. Having a blast with getting dogs out more, going new places, more trails and woods. We're all loving it.
That's good. You know what? We are seeing, agreed. Mm-hmm. We are seeing more people, though, on the city streets.
Oh, yeah.
Walking their dogs. Yeah. But on trails and stuff, no, like we did two off-leash excursions today, and but we go to places where there's nobody. Just because we don't want to see anybody. We don't want to see anybody. Next.
We've been social distancing before it was a thing.
Yeah.
With the dogs anyway.
Yeah. From each other. Get away from me.
Yeah. Right. Hey guys, my 12-week-old boxer seems to show territorial behavior with my other dog. Bites at her when we give her attention and always has to be the closest to us. What should we do about this?
Teach your dog. Who's that?
Justin.
Justin, go to my YouTube channel. I've got a couple of videos titled Out. One of them means out, meaning literally get the fuck out of here. Okay? What you're doing is, and this is literally how you set it up. Like, I don't know if it shows this in the video. It might show it in the video. But you can actually call your other dog up to you. And you say to your other, the dog that's actually has to be first, you say out, that dog will end up actually walking, if not running away. That's the end result, and it doesn't take long. The video shows you how to do it. It's a free video. Lots of free content up there on social, on my YouTube channel. But use my YouTube channel, guys. Please use it. Next.
Sophia, he has his e-collar on for most of the day, yes. For instance, instead of playing, he'll just stand around and stare into nothingness. LOL.
All right. So what I would do is stop putting LSD inside his food. Step one, right? Step two, tell the dog what to do. I mean, unless you don't mind. I mean, I'll walk in here and every once in a while, Bert is just sitting down, just like looking at shit.
He does just stare.
He just stares. And I'm like, that's right. I've got a pretty face, Bert. Thanks for thinking the same thing. He's like, oh, I was looking at something on the wall. I was like, oh, sorry, Bert. So, I mean, just tell your dog to go do something. Go to place. Next.
Hoku, if my dog is barking or rushing the door because she hears stuff outside, how do I correct it with the e-collar or prong?
However is best for you. I mean, if you're standing right there. So ideally, a remote collar for a dog rushing a door is a fantastic tool because you can almost be anywhere. It's a fantastic tool to use. And you make it suck to rush the door. And every once in a while, someone will say, well, how about if someone's trying to break in? Get a fucking gun. You know what I mean? It's like, you know, I mean, I'm very aware of home defense. I'm very aware of that. Trust me. But when it comes down to it, your dog is going to rush the door, like, for the Amazon delivery person. And for Amazon delivery people, for UPS, for Federal Express, for the local mail carrier, thank you all so much for working. Obviously, our doctors and nurses as well, but also for everybody that's out there working right now, thank you, that's making sure we get our packages and our mail. Mm-hmm. Thanks for bringing me my bills that we can't pay right now. I appreciate it. Next.
Steph, normally I can verbally call my dog off of rabbits, but today she sniffed out a nest and I had to crank the e-collar to 100 and still had to kick her off the nest. Normal, what to do in the future?
What you can do is I would go find that nest again and I would put the dog on a long line. And as soon as the dog walks over to the nest and at the beginning stages of its sniffing, I'd correct that dog high and give some leash guidance backwards. And make sure your e-collar has got proper fit. Dogs blow through remote collars. Dogs blow through underground fences, which are way more powerful than e-collars. And a lot of times they do it voluntarily, knowing they're going to be corrected and corrected high. So, you know, what's on the other side of the underground fence? It's worth the correction, you know? So, you know, I've had dogs that blow through 100. I own a dog that will easily blow through 100.
Me too.
You know, he's a Mal. Like 100, he goes in drive, you know? But he'll blow through 100 out of drive. He'll blow through 100 just looking at something sometimes. In drive, what do I do with this? Nothing. Next.
Kathy, this doesn't make sense. I'm wondering if part of it got cut off. She said no cars, though, no people. I was ready to sleep in the woods to find him.
Oh, she probably lost her dog.
Yeah.
Unless she was looking for the rabbits. Did Kathy ask another question prior to that?
No, she just said they've been going on off-leash trail hikes.
Oh, that's not good.
Lillian, tips for training more than one dog?
Kathy, if you get, there's more to that question, just
type it.
Retype it. Tips for training more than one dog, and then at the same time, train one at a time. First train one at a time, baseline stuff, then you can train them both at the same time. Mm-hmm. One at a time, and have one dog in a crate or on place, on a tie back, or out of the room, all right? So training, you have to teach your foundation stuff, guys. You got to teach your foundation stuff. So there's no shortcuts to basic obedience. No. So there's no shortcuts to basic obedience. Next.
We always say to our owners, me and Britt, two dogs is three times the training.
At least three times the training.
Separately and then together.
Yep. Yep. It sure is.
$4.99 from Holden on Dog Training.
Oh, thanks, Ashley.
He's a jerk, but not a bad dog. Just freaking dramatic. It's ridiculous. I correct for nonsense. He ramps it up more. He's bipolar or just a jerk.
Hey, don't be knocking the bipolars out there. Listen, or the jerks out there. This is the thing. No, the dog's not understanding the conversation. Ashley, the dog is not understanding the conversation. So take a deep breath, step back, teach the dog the conversation. What are you trying to communicate with the dog? Right? But are there dogs out there that are like Groundhog Day? Yep, we got some in here right now. Got a couple of them in here right now. And they can't get picked up for a while. So what I would do is I'd be like, also, this could be the messy middle. A lot of dogs struggle. A lot of dogs resist against information because there's nothing in it for them. We see that a lot. Next.
Kathy, above is part one of Ready to Sleep in the Woods. I don't see it. It might be too long.
It might be too long.
But YouTube won't let it come through.
Yeah, we did not see it. We did not see it.
Hmm.
Here it is. Oh, but my one dog, not e-collar trained, and e-collar trained, both dog took off after a deer. Yeah, holy shit.
Why don't I see that?
Holy shit. Right below Ashley's top chat. Huh. Holy shit. Scary. Got the e-collar dog back when stamped other dog did come back, but damn scary. Yeah. It can be scary.
It just showed up on my screen. That's so weird.
Yeah, it can be scary. That's the problem is like, you know, losing your dog sucks. And there's a lot of environmentals out there. But deer, moose, like which will keep running and running and running. At least a squirrel jumps up a freaking tree. At least it's hopefully the dog will stop. But deer, I ain't seen too many deer climb tree.
No.
You ever seen a deer climb a tree?
Can't say I have.
I wonder if it's happening and we don't know about it.
Maybe. They're like, well, they're in the deer stands looking for us in the trees. We might as well go up there and...
check them out.
No, trick them.
Trick them.
They're in the deer stands looking down.
You think they're jumping on people and shit?
Maybe.
They could. Nipping them, biting their ears off.
Maybe.
How many one-eared hunters are there, you think? Probably not many, so it's probably not happening. Mm. Yeah. Next.
Holding on dog training. Top chat won't let you cuss. I had to edit what I really thought. Thanks for the push and guidance. Love y'all.
Well, you're welcome, hon.
Jessica, do you always start teaching the out command with food?
No, we teach out command. We teach it with any resource.
Sometimes I just teach it with spatial pressure.
Yeah.
Just tell the dog to get out of my way.
Yeah.
So you
claiming claiming of space. Mm-hmm. You can do the claiming of space exercise, spatial pressure exercise. But food is always a good one to do because a lot of folks are struggling with resource guarding of food. So that's one that people can relate to a lot. But dogs can resource anything. And you know what they resource a lot of is humans, their owners. Mm-hmm. Next.
Kathy said shit. Don't worry, Kathy. We read it. I found it.
Yeah.
Giraffe, I have a dog, 10 months, that has a good recall when we are training recall with a long leash and or e-collar, but her recall is generally not very reliable. Sometimes she doesn't even come when I stand at the front door and say come to let her out. I've resorted to asking her to sit and stay instead, and I walk myself to her instead.
Sounds like your dog is a good human trainer.
Oh, instead of letting her ignore the come command. Good. Any tips?
So what I would do is You need to do more reps. Your dog needs to understand, after you've done hundreds of reps, what a correction for non-compliance is. And the dog's remote collar trained. Dogs have a remote collar on. Everyone thinks a remote collar is for like off-leash excursion in the woods. It's like, do you know how many dogs don't come back in from their potty breaks? And yeah. The owners literally can't go to work?
He's trying to just get the dog to come across the house.
Yeah. There's so many dogs that literally, though, are like, why are you late? Why are you 30 minutes late to work? My dog wouldn't come in from the bathroom break. How, what do you got, 10 acres? No, it's like 100 feet to this way, 50 feet to that way. My dog was playing keep away the whole damn time, mm-hmm. You know? So, you know, recall is recall. Next.
Yep. I can't tell you how many times I recall my dogs inside, just in the training center. They'll try to like rush back there. And I'm like, here.
Oh, yeah. I got to recall like, your dogs
just,
all the time.
They just run around everywhere. They don't know how to walk.
Yep. Joel's going to make a shake or making a salad or grabbing a snack. And the dogs are like, maybe we're going outside because there's a potty door out there too. Mm-hmm. Well, potty door. That's one of our bathroom areas back there as well. And then pretty soon the swimming pool. Not pretty soon. A couple more weeks. We'll see.
Soon.
I'll probably go to the house and open up the swimming pool soon.
Cool.
You know, that's going to be a project this year.
Yeah.
I had somebody do it last year.
Oh.
But I didn't pay anybody this year to do it. I didn't pay anybody to do anything this year.
All right.
Next.
Bruno, cheers from Brazil. Would like to thank you for the great balanced content. My working line German Shepherd has not been exposed to other dogs, just people. Will she have problems when I get a male GSD?
I would get your dog. I don't know. It could be a catch 20. It could be a 50-50 chance. I would try to get your dog a little bit more exposure. You know, get your dog socialized a little bit more. Next. But then again, on the other side, you get dogs that are you get dogs that are well socialized with other dogs. Bring home another dog, dog fight.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's what I mean. You never know.
You never know. Yep. Hoku, how do I get my dog to get into the car? Can I use an e-collar?
No. Leash on the dog. Teach your dog to get in. The concept that you push a button on a remote collar and your dog is going to do something is not necessarily the case. You can get it to stop doing something. That's the case. Getting into the trash, getting in the litter box, eating shit, digging holes, fence fighting. But this concept that if you don't know the down command and I push a button and you're going to fly into a down is false.
Mm-hmm.
No different than we food train here. Here's food. You're a food motivated dog. Down. Dog's like, I don't know what down is. You still got to train the dog. So how do you get a dog into a car? Leash on the dog. And do we have a video on that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have a video on that. We filmed that.
Let's go.
Seminar. Usually almost at every seminar.
Oh, I don't think we have like an official one. I thought you meant the funny one. The funny one from the podcast.
Oh.
You're like, cut me up some chicken. Cut me up some steak. And then I'll come over and push your dog into the car.
Hey, Melissa, can you do me a favor if you have time?
That was like the first like funny one I think we ever put out.
Can you look for that video?
OG.
Can you look for that video and send that to me? Or Mackenzie, if you're watching this. But
we were at Julie's house in Frederick.
We were?
Yeah.
A lot of funny ones happened at Frederick.
I know. That was before the baby, though. That was like the OG like funny video.
That was really at Julie's house?
Yeah. Yep.
I'm just trying to think. You know what? Whenever we talk about videos from the road, you know what the first thing I think of? Backdrops.
Yes.
Like the wall behind us.
It was Julie's house.
Because we can identify like where we were by literally like what's behind us.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh yeah, that's so-and-so's wall.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That was a freaking funny ass video.
Next.
Kathy, maybe the ... messed it up. He has an awesome recall or did. Damn dear. I really am blaming myself though. I have work to do now.
So Kathy, don't give yourself a hard time. This is what I want you to do. I've had a dog that have blown through a dog turn 1900 at 127 who had impeccable recall. Impeccable. When I say impeccable, imagine a ball crazy dog will do anything for a ball. Anything for a ball. I'd throw that ball, I'd play a game. How close can I get Uma, who's dead now, but how close can I get Uma to that ball before I recall her and she doesn't keep going? We're talking, I got her right up to it. She would turn so damn quick, her body would keep going backwards. Probably not the best thing for her anatomy. Her body would keep going backwards because she wanted to get back to me so quick. Okay, and she blew off recall for a deer. So guess what I did? get to the woods, let your dog be 20 feet away from you, call your dog back, correct high. Geez, you didn't even give the dog a chance to get back to you. Oh, well, you should have been a mind reader, dog. Dogs aren't supposed to be mind readers, but what you're doing is you're putting your dog on alert going, guess what? I know you're off leash. And you don't do this normally. These are for dogs that don't respond. These are dogs that, just like what Kathy described, you know, but I would also do more reps on recall. Next.
Melissa said, don't feel bad, Joelle. I can't see that comment at all. YouTube must be acting funny this evening.
I'm hardwired into our system here. So slow. But Wi-Fi has been acting weird probably everywhere. Why?
Everybody's on the internet.
I don't think people realize this also. When everybody in the house is on Wi-Fi, like every device is sucking up 15% of your Wi-Fi. So at the training center, we have 300-300. We got 300 download, 300 upload, which is really, really fast.
Super fast.
So, and some days, if you're on Wi-Fi, it's slow. Yeah. And even on Wi-Fi with multiple devices on.
I couldn't even load my YouTube page today.
I'm hardwired in. I ran a line from the router over to here because we were having a problem. We were having a problem for a while. Remember that?
Yeah.
I don't know if it was on a show or it was just... I couldn't even get work done. I couldn't even send out an email. Mm-hmm. Next.
Sophia, this is probably a dumb question, LOL. When working CS, can each training session have a different command? Yes, it should.
It should, actually.
We do 3 to 4 sessions daily, or should I keep it simple and cycle through 1 to 2 commands?
No, teach one command at a time and use your leash for guidance if you have to, which you most likely do, because you're trying to teach the dog, because the remote collar is not directional. Remember, you're using it to still layer your existing training.
As long as you're priming the dog at the beginning of the session, so they know what you're working on.
Explain what priming is.
So priming is, with our board and train, we don't go, oh, today we're only teaching down on the remote. Like, I can have a down session, Brittany can have a recall session, but what we do before we start working the remote is prime the dog. So we'll use the word here. And that's it. It's like, okay, this session, we'll do 5 reps. Dog recalls to us every time. Right. It's like...
With no remote collar.
No remote collar.
Right.
And it's like, okay, now we're working on remote. So we take the word away.
Yep.
Pressure goes on. Dog's like, well, we've been working on recall for 10 minutes now. What else am I going to do?
Right.
They're not going to just offer some random behavior when you've been patterning.
They do sometimes, but that's the what priming
But that's
means.
Why you have a leash to help them out.
Yeah, that's why leash. Guys, please leave your leashes on longer. Please give your dogs more guidance. Please give your dogs more education. It's so important when it comes to obedience.
No, it's funny because sometimes, like, if Brittany, like, if she'll have a play session with a dog and then I start recall.
Play session or play?
Place.
Place.
With, like, with CS.
Yes.
And then I take the dog and do recall. Sometimes they will. They'll run to place. And I'm like, Brittany, did you just do place with this dog?
Right.
She's like, yeah, I did.
Yeah.
They do. They start to offer behavior.
Yep. Nice.
Edwin, hey Jeff, how do you correct a 6-month GSP puppy that gets very exciting when people greet? High on e-collar? Thank you for your review.
No, not high on e-collar. Use your prong collar leash and correct in a downward way. Excited or just correct in general. The dog it's all an arousal issue. And it's like, your dog's not going to hate people. It's like, people are like, oh, he's happy to see me. Okay, that turns into grandma breaking her hip. Okay, that's what it's going to turn into. I'm all for happy-go-lucky dogs, trust me. But I've seen too many injuries happen from, oh, my dog is just excited. I'm like, can you call 911 because grandma just broke her hip? Or my 4-year-old just got his face scratched. I really don't care that your dog is excited. Your dog just injured my child. So, and in 2020, which people are suing, you're fucked. You're fucked. Next.
A Bataglia. Hey, J&J. I brought home my first foster.
Oh.
Existence with Lucy is going excellent. He was choking out on a slip lead. Prong collar was a game changer.
Yep.
Totally walks at my side. Now doing thresholds and crate.
Awesome. Good.
Thank you for the great content. It's helped me, and now I'm helping others.
Awesome.
Love you guys.
One of the greatest gifts you can do is the helping of other people.
True story. Next. Kathy, I will e-collar train him. He's soft, but a border collie, so his drive is really high. That feeling when they just keep on running, nauseous. I knew you'd understand that.
Yeah. So, you know, even soft dogs. Guys, remote collars are not just for, you know, hard to train dogs or challenging dogs. We look at a remote collar as an important communication device that can go up to a mile away. They actually have even hunter ones. They, you know, Garmin makes some different ones. They've got the big boxes for some of my hunting friends. We'll use to go. I think one of my buddies in Australia's got, I think he's like 8 miles. He can look on his phone, or he's got his little GPS. He's like, yep, there's my dog, because they chase pigs. They corner pigs. He's a pig hunter. A boar. Actually, I shouldn't say pig, like boar hunter. So what happens is, man, it fucking sucks when your dog runs away and you're like, and you know, you're like,
I'm fucked.
You're like, you're not coming back, are you? Yeah. I mean, you just know. You feel it.
That happened once with Wes.
Yeah. It's the...
After a deer.
Yeah, it is
so
the...
So is those damn deer.
It is the... One of the worst feelings in the world.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Oh. I'd rather go to my proctologist, frankly. You know? Next.
Hoku, in one training session, 30 to 60 minutes, how many different things can I work on to not overwhelm my dog?
I don't know your dog. I don't know your skill set. I don't know you. Why don't you just work on one thing at a time, spend 15 minutes doing it, and then break it up? Okay? Try different things. Try different things. Hoku, be like, I'm going to say one thing, another trainer's going to say another thing. So try what works for you. Try what works for you. Just don't confuse the dog. How do you know if the dog's confused? Some people want to just train too much. But on a puppy, when you're working with a high energy puppy, we're using its daily food, you can run the dog through all its commands, because you're just like, you're doing luring. You're just doing luring. That's all you're doing. And you don't care about, you know, duration work, and you don't care about a lot of stuff. You're just like having fun with the dog. Next. Yeah.
Justin, what age can we start e-collar training for my puppy?
You can start, we start dogs on 14 weeks old. Now, let's clarify that though. We're not correcting the dog. You know, we're not correcting the dog at 14 weeks old. We're using, again, we are layering the remote collar, which is a communication device. It's so important that people understand that. There needs to be more education out there about remote collars. And we've been putting out education. I've been talking about remote collars before anybody was talking about remote collars. I was talking about remote collars, and people that were remote collar only trainers, they didn't even put it on their website that that's how they trained. I mean, I remember back when I had my radio show, I was talking about them, and I'm like, why am I the only one talking about these things? It's not because I'm the only one that's using them. And I understand that a lot of people are against them. I get it. Okay. I've seen your emails. Okay. So, but you just don't understand.
Yeah.
You just don't. I'm sorry. You don't understand. But this concept that they're harming dogs. You know what? Yelling at your dog harms your dog. Yelling at your dog harms your dog.
Do you know what's like interesting though? The pet dog world is so different from like hunt dog world.
Oh, they have no idea.
They have no idea that people don't like remote collars.
Yes, I know. I've met
them. Like, I know some, and they're like, wait, people are against these?
Yes.
Like,
here's a great example. We just started using squirt bottles here.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you what. Why? Because there was a couple of dogs here that nothing was working. We started using squirt bottles. Now, here's something really interesting. We're using them to stop, obviously, unwanted behaviors, which a lot, that's what you use a squirt bottle for. Somebody could be like, oh, I would never use a remote collar. That's mean and cruel. But I use a squirt bottle. Okay. We have dogs that don't care about a remote collar. Therefore, it's not a proper punisher to that dog, but are horrified by the squirt bottle. So, if we all started thinking rationally, which is not being done, that squirt bottle is a bigger punisher to the dog. The dog perceives it as a bigger punisher. So you're okay with a squirt bottle, but you're not okay with a shock collar. But to the dog doesn't give a flying Frank Sinatra about the shock collar for a correction, but is horrified by the squirt bottle. And when we're trying to stop an unwanted behavior, that's all that matters, is that you find something intolerable, and it does not have to be painful. It does not have to be painful at all. Dogs will stop. How many people use penny cans? Mm-hmm. Shaking a penny can. I just find them impractical, you know? But I'm just saying, though, is like, that doesn't hurt. Dogs don't like that. How many dogs don't like, you know, a lot of things? It doesn't have to be pain. So this conversation out there that, like, you need to inflict pain or discomfort in your dog to get to stop things is, no, you just need to find something intolerable to stop things.
Exactly.
Now, there are some things, like, you bite me, oh, it's going to suck physically for you. Yep, I said that. Turn that into a soundbite. Go ahead and duplicate it. Put it out there. I'm sorry. Because why? You're dead if I don't. Wake up, world. You're dead. Biting dogs historically don't live long. They don't. So that needs to be stopped. Next.
Whoa, I just wanted to rant.
Was it?
That was quite a rant.
Really? Oh, yeah. I thought I was answering a question.
Misty. Might be a dumb question, but are there different methods used for older dogs who are misbehaved? A friend of mine has an elderly dog he's trying to train and doesn't know where to start.
Okay, so first of all, I want everybody to please stop saying this might be a dumb question. It's not a dumb question. Do you know why it's not a dumb question? You don't know. Therefore, you're asking. Therefore, it's not a dumb question. I will not treat it as a dumb question. I don't think it's a dumb question. So, where to start? Go to my do-it-yourself. I don't know what the dog knows or doesn't know, and you don't have to tell me here because it doesn't matter. But start at my do-it-yourself 2020 how-to series on how to train a dog. Next. It's free. It's on YouTube. Start there.
Kathy, it changed my mind on only using on the harder dog. Shit, that's terrifying. Ignored all recall. You are absolutely correct. It's a great communication tool. Learn my lesson.
It sure is. It's a fantastic communication tool. Next.
Steven just got a pup and he hates his crate. I've been trying to train it like a place command, but eventually he'll refuse to go in. Closed door equals a total freak out. Any tips?
Tons of tips. Yeah, your dog's got crate anxiety, separation anxiety. Yep. Make it, that's a good example. We talked about that today during the shooting of the video of the separation anxiety. Make it suck. Don't treat it as the place command. Treat it as the crate command. Kennel up. Close the door. Come out. Like I said earlier in the show. Do drills. Do kennel drills. But if the dog is freaking out, how old is the dog? 7 month old?
Just got a pup.
Just got a pup. Oh, okay. But even an 8, 9, 10 week old pup who hates the crate, it's not because they have to go to the bathroom most likely, all right? Then the dog might, but this doesn't seem like it, okay? By the line of the questioning, the dog just doesn't like the crate. A lot of people say, make the crate fun. But how do you exactly do that? What do you do? Put in fucking puzzles and video games and frozen things with food inside, if you want. But what happens when you run out of that? Now you got a barking dog. Then you got to do another one. Now you got a barking fat ass dog that still doesn't like the fucking crate. Okay? 2 a.m. What the fuck's going on? I'm fucking hungry over here.
Bring me my food.
All right. Present. I woke up and there wasn't a, there. Where's the buffet? The buffet is gone.
10 weeks old, a puppy.
10 weeks old, yeah. So you can correct it. How do you correct it? Bonker. Bonk it. Hit the top of the crate. Hit the side of the crate. Take the food bowl if it's a metallic food bowl. Oh my God, the dog will hit the crate more.
Try a squirt bottle.
We're not seeing that. We do not see that. We are not seeing the act of correcting a dog in a crate, okay, for inappropriate behavior, destroy the relationship with the owner, get the dog to hate the crate. I am not seeing that. I've done it 10,000 plus times. So have my clients, if not hundreds of thousands of times. All we are seeing dogs is do this. I think I'll go in my crate, lie down, and shut up and be calm. And it's not because you shut them down. It's because they learned that's not how you behave. Simple concepts. All right, next.
Barista boy. Yes, the Garmin Astro. My uncle uses it for his beagle for rabbits.
Yeah.
Jokes, he looks like an alien with the long satellite wire, but on the receiver, you can actually see other hunting dogs if other hunters have made it public. Pretty cool.
Oh, wow. Yeah. It is pretty cool. So it's called the Astro, the Garmin Astro. Yeah. I didn't know that. Thank you. I didn't know the name of it.
Barista boy also said, for the squirt bottles, do you use the mist or the direct squirt?
Direct squirt.
Direct squirt.
Make it suck. Still got to make it suck for them. Yeah, they hate it. It's working on it. Two dogs in particular here at the same time. Yeah. Yep. But it's all that also has to be used properly, too.
Very.
That also has to be used properly. Don't use it like a weapon. Don't be like, don't use it as a threat.
Yep.
Like, the dog's barking, and we use it for very specific things.
Yeah.
Very specific things. It's not like we use it for like, and don't threaten the dog. You don't want to threaten the dog.
No, you want to be stealth about it.
Yeah, but it's like, ooh, every time I pick up the squirt bottle, just like anything else, it's no different. Every time I
pick up the receiver
of the remote, it's like, no. It's not the way you do it. That's not how you correct a dog. You don't make threats. And people do that with their kids, and they do that with their dogs, and they never follow through. And that's why they don't have consistency. Next.
Terry, why is it that people feel it's better to use training tools that emit sound as opposed to the e-collar? If misused, both can harm your pet.
Anything can harm your pet. Put it this way. 99% of the dogs that come in here with really, really bad behaviors, we specialize in a lot of aggression here. They've never had a remote collar on. What happened? They were abused. No, they weren't. What happened? Too much love, too much affection, not enough rules, not enough consequences, not holding the dog accountable, not enough proactive training, not from bad owners. This concept, oh, there's no bad dogs, there's just bad owners. No, I hate that fucking phrase. That's so disrespectful to owners that are busting their ass out there. There's just a lack of communication. And there are some dogs out there that are really, really bad. That doesn't make, you know, badly behaved, I should say. I should rephrase that. And then there's some dangerous dogs out there. You know, we see them. We're supposed to stand up, breathe,
yes.
Sit down.
Stupid things been telling me to stand all day. I got work to do.
Yeah,
I didn't stand a lot today. I was on my computer a lot today.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter, okay? Take the 12 hours from yesterday and fucking add it to today. Can you do that? Hey, pay attention there, watch. Give me some credit.
Freaking asshole watch.
Okay.
A Bataglia. First night with the foster, he started whining in the crate. Marked it and bunked the crate. 3 quiet nights since. Blessed.
See that? You marked it as probably with no. Told the dog to shut up. Yeah, we have a dog here that was a humongous crate breaker. Not anymore.
Nope.
Not anymore.
Steph, my dog can ignore the e-collar, but don't come near her with a squirt bottle. End of the world.
See that? There you go.
I think, honestly, on a day that I just washed my hair, I'd take an e-collar correction over a freaking squirt bottle. Don't fuck with my hair.
I was going to say, what does that have to do with washing your hair?
That's a punisher. This is a lot of work.
Oh.
Somebody come at me and spray my hair. I'll be like, just correct me with the e-collar, please.
Really?
Yeah. I'd take it.
Okay.
Yeah, I think I'd perceive that as more of a punisher.
That you just said the magic word, perceive.
Mm-hmm.
How does the dog perceive it? Some dogs don't perceive a lot of things certain ways.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it worked on that dog, doesn't work on this dog. It's like literally the dog, how the dog perceives it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where like a lot of stuff, dogs perceive things good and bad differently.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if that falls within the parameters of acceptable behavior, that's fine. But if it doesn't fall in the parameters of acceptable behavior, that has to be tweaked. So we change things up. Next.
Terry G, by the way, love all your content. Bonkers are fantastic.
Bonkers are fantastic. Yes, they are. Bonkers are a game changer. Just don't make a videotape of you using one. Unless you want to end up on the front page of Scotland's biggest newspaper. Like, guys, come on. You have nothing else to write about? Next.
Katie. Having trouble finding the working level for my Akita pup. I watched your video on it, but she gives no cues until I'm up in the 20s, which has to be well past her working level.
Says who? So number
That's
one...
That's probably hard to get contact on an Akita, too.
Check fit. I would use the thick fur contact points, not just the long ones.
You might even have to like thin down the hair.
Thin down the hair a little bit. Yeah, whenever we say shave the dog's neck, we're not shaving it down to bare skin.
No.
But you need to make sure it's on nice and snug. Take the collar and go like this.
You can part the fur too. So make a part like so that you see their skin and put the contact. It's kind of a pain, but then you at least know you have good contact.
But also it's like, it's just a number. But also you can start at 20. Next thing you know, 15 minutes later, you're down to 5 is the working level. You'd be surprised. We see that all the time. Next.
Bruno, we have too much of the all positive training down here in Brazil. Few good trainers. Before you got to where you are now, how hard was it to convince clients?
So, Bruno, it's like that everywhere. I've never convinced a client of anything. I'm very transparent, if you can't tell. My website is transparent. My videos are transparent. I'm transparent. I don't convince owners of anything. If you don't want to hire me, do not hire me. It's on you. It's on you. It's a free world. You know? Well, at least the U.S. is a free world. You know? Even though you can't leave your house. So, you know, I mean.
Had to throw that in there.
Or go shopping.
Or do anything. Really. Anyway.
No. I was just thinking about a post someone put up about, like, all these things that are open, but in Massachusetts, I guess some gun shops are closed. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. In Rhode Island, gun shops are still open. Yeah. So. Yep. Next.
Boston Mike. My dog is scared to ride in the car. Any way to get him over that?
Yeah. What you can do is this. Number one, get your dog to go in the car and go into a down. So load up, get in the car, down. Load up, get in the car, and so practice that over and over and over again, and then start taking drives and keeping the dog into a down, in a down stay. So what you're doing is you can't convince the dog that the car is not scary. What you need to do is just have lots of different experiences of the dog realizing that the world's not coming to an end. That's how you get dogs over fear, by just doing it. By just doing it.
That's it.
That's all we got?
Yep. 7:55.
Yeah. What do you want to talk about?
I don't know.
We're going to do last rotation tonight.
Yeah.
Last rotation.
Really can't wait to get this hat off my head, to be honest. It's like giving me a headache, I think.
Is that too tight?
No.
Hmm.
Steven says, I'm in Kentucky where liquor stores are an essential business.
Yeah, they're essential.
They're still open here,
They're still open here, too. Yeah.
We just had that conversation. It's like, why?
Right.
So weird.
Yeah. I think, well, some states, like I'm from Ohio originally, beer and wine was available. When we travel across the country, we see like you can buy, like our convenience stores, like 7-Eleven, you can't buy alcohol in Rhode Island. But I can't tell you, or a gas station. But I can't tell you, when we travel in the RV, like that you can buy, usually just beer. I don't think I've seen, have you seen hard liquor at a
No.
But then again, they got drive-through ones too, you know? So yeah, I mean, alcohol is I guess, considered an essential. And for some people, it is essential. Someone like me who doesn't drink at all, I can give a flying fuck about it. But I get it though. I mean, I get it. Next.
Jackie, hi from the UK. Don't have an e-collar. Just wondering, what is the next best thing for correcting on-lead arousal?
On-lead arousal, a bonker. A bonker is going to help, or a prong collar pop down. Start it in the house. You know, start it literally before you go out the door for a walk. Correct the dog. Bonk the dog before you even go out. If the dog's already scanning, if the dog's already, you know, trust me, I want the dog to like the walk too. But right now, you don't like the walk. So it's also about the human too. No, you know what I mean? Next.
Barista boy, I know you won't give advice. You don't fully stand by, but do you have any good tips for crust around a dog's eye? Have trouble removing it sometimes.
I don't know. I mean, I just take, you know, my finger and just remove it. What do you do?
Same, or a warm washcloth.
Warm washcloth, you know? Nail, you know, use a Dremel. You know, just use a Dremel and just Dremel that shit off. Stop it.
You know? He's joking. Warm washcloth, can't go wrong with that, right?
I guess not. Yeah.
Get it checked out medically. Could be allergies. Could be a lot of things.
Could be a lot of things. Yep.
Leanne, these videos are so helpful.
Oh, thank you.
Rick says, just checking in. Hi from Trapper and Rick.
Oh, hey, Rick.
Hey, Rick. Jackie, P.S. He is good passing by most things, but but cats or dogs in his face, he does not know. Gets bonked, but his...
Yeah, so, okay. So, this is the thing. Dogs shouldn't be in your dog's face on the walk.
His reactions are so quick.
Yeah. Dogs' faces shouldn't be in your dog's face in the walk. So that's more about you having a better structured walk and keeping other dogs away. Cats? What do you live in, New Orleans? Cats are walking up to you?
Coming right up to the dog?
They do, I guess. Just kick the cat. But don't let dogs come up to your dogs. Don't let dogs... I'm not surprised. I mean, I wouldn't let a dog run into my dog's face and then correct it. No. It's like, no, you dog. I correct the other dog. Get out of here. You know, get out of here. I don't want you. I don't want you in my face. You know? You gotta advocate for your dog too.
Yeah.
You gotta advocate for your dog too. It's really, really important. Next.
A. Battaglia. Lucy stares off at dogs who lunge and fence fight when walking on lead. She never has been aggressive, but I feel like I should correct. Advice?
Stares off at dogs who lunge and fence fight when walking on... No! I mean, just looks at them?
Yeah, just like, hey, look, a dog. Acting like a jerk over there.
Really?
No big deal.
No big deal. We got two thumbs down on this one. Oh, sad. Two people don't like the show. Oh, well. Yeah. There is an exit button. Could get off the show. You know, you...
Everyone's quarantined, though.
You do realize that. YouTube's got a lot of options out there. A lot of options. You know what I would say to folks like that? In a world of negativity, right now is a good time to just, like, log off the fucking show. Instead of just, like, I can care how many thumbs down I get, you know? But it's just, like... There's so much out. Like, now's a really good time to work on your fucking hate, guys. It really is. Mm. It's a good time to work on your hate and look for love and be kind. It really, really is. All right? So, you ain't gonna hurt my fucking feelings, I'll tell you that much. All right, guys. Hold on. There's one more, and then we're gonna go. We're gonna head out.
All right, Demon Dog Buddy. I adopted my 3-year-old dog about 5 months ago. He's extremely dog reactive. He has since been really calmed down, but he still focuses on dogs when passing. Sometimes he ignores what to do.
So is he reacting? He reacts or just focuses on them?
Focuses.
So if he just focuses on them, you can just give him a correction for that. All right. All right, guys. It's a 1-hour show. We're over by 1.8 seconds. All right. We'll take everyone. Talk to everyone later. Don't forget tomorrow, 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And what we're doing is in our Patreon channel, we are doing, I'm going to start doing Zooms. And what you can do is, you could join the Patreon channel if you're not in there. And if you are in there, don't forget. I'll be on, we'll be here Wednesday night, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time as well. Madly in love with you. Talk to all of you later. Everybody have a fantastic week, and let's all work on ourselves.